Hi guys, welcome you all to my channel Explore Edu to Deep.
The next topic that we'll be studying today in Digital Electronics Sequential Circuits part is going to be SR flip-flop, that is clocked SR flip-flop. So in the last class we have learned various concepts of SR latch, NAND gates, NOR gates. So that is already uploaded on my YouTube channel playlist as well as on my Instagram page also, so you can go and watch it from there. That forms the basis to your SR flip-flop as clocked circuit. So you have to be very clear with those. If you understand latch well, you can understand the clock part also very well. So let's try to understand what is SR flip-flop as clocked flip-flop. So if I just consider this diagram, there are two inputs, that is S and the R. There is a clock input and this is the NAND SR latch kind of circuit. So what is happening is that along with this SR NAND latch circuit, you have this clocked input which is present over here. Hence this is called as SR flip-flop as a clocked flip-flop. So I hope I am very clear with this and you are understanding the concept very well. So this particular circuit stands for the SR flip-flop as clocked, in which you have this SR NAND latch flip-flop which is already explained in the earlier class, and it is attached with these two gates which will give SR flip-flop as a clocked circuit. So I hope I am very clear with this. Now what is the truth table for SR flip-flop as a clocked circuit? So if you see, there is an additional parameter as clock over here. So when it is low, my output remains same as that of my previous value Qn. So my next state Qn plus 1 will be equal to Qn if my clock remains the same. However, if the clock goes up, different set of input values will give different outputs. So we will discuss that one by one. So when the clock is high and the S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0, irrespective of my Qn, this cross means irrespective of Qn, my Qn plus 1 is equal to Qn. If the clock is high and the S and the R is 0 and 1, irrespective of my Qn, my output will always be 0, that is in reset condition. If my clock is high and my S and R is equal to 1 and 0 respectively, irrespective of my Qn plus 1 is always going to be set. And if my clock is high and my S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, irrespective of Qn, my output will always be in forbidden condition. That means, forbidden always means that my Qn plus 1 and Qn plus 1 bar both will be equal to 1, which is not possible. If 1 is equal to 1, the complementary has to be equal to 0, the vice versa. So this is very important. So this particular circuit diagram and this truth table, entire proper page is uploaded on my Instagram page as well. So you can see that particular page also and follow me on Instagram. The links are given down in the description box as well. So basically this is a SR flip-flop, clocked flip-flop, in which we have a SR NAND latch which is associated to a clocked circuit. This is a truth table for the same. So what is the disadvantage of SR flip-flop that we have to go for the other flip-flops in the future? See, what happens is that if you have seen, when the clock is high and the S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, my output goes into forbidden condition. What do you mean by forbidden condition? That is, both my Qn plus 1 and Qn plus 1 bar, both of them will be equal to 1. That is not possible, right? If your Qn plus 1 is equal to 1, my Qn plus 1 bar will always be equal to 0, the opposite of it. And hence, this is a drawback. It's not possible that S is equal to 1, R is equal to 1. So Qn and Qn plus 1 and Qn plus 1 bar both will be equal to 1. It's not possible. Now, we have this question which has been asked in the GATE examination. We'll try to understand this particular question, very beautiful question, and we'll try to understand the solution as well. So you see, what does the question say? There are two inputs X and Y, as you can see in the question, given to a NAND latch in the sequence. So a NAND latch diagram is given to you. and the P and the Q is given. By giving you different input conditions such as x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, and x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, and what are going to be the corresponding P and Q values for this set of inputs. So from the NAND latch truth table, if you see, if your x is equal to 0 and your y is equal to 1, so I just go back. If you see the NAND latch truth table, when my x is equal to 0 and your R is equal to 1, that is both inputs are 0 and 1, if you see in this question, they have just converted that to x and 1. So when it is 0 and 1, my output is going to be 1 and 0. That is the standard truth table output. You can refer my notes. They are uploaded in the description box of my YouTube channel as well. There is a particular video also in the description in the digital electronics playlist. You can watch it from there. So when x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 for a NAND latch input, my output is going to be 1 and 0. And when my x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, my output is basically indeterminate. Okay, indeterminate means, I told you P is equal to 1 and Q is also equal to 1. These both are complementary to each other. So it's not possible that my P and Q both are equal to 1. Either one has to be 0, other has to be 1. Either one has to be 1, the other output has to be 0. But this is not possible. So what you can consider in this particular question is that when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1 is a forbidden condition. But in ideal scenario, my gates are not going to be very ideal. The gates are going to be non-ideal. So as I mentioned over here, these NAND gates which are given over here are non-ideal NAND gates. So if I consider the gate 1 might have more delay than gate 2, the gate 2 might have more delay than gate 1. So that is something very important for you to understand. So when my x is equal, so as you understand that, when your x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, p is equal to 1, q is equal to 0. Now when my x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1, the output is an indeterminate condition. From the truth table also, if you see for an AND gate, it is in an indeterminate condition. And hence, I am writing indeterminate as p is equal to 1 and q is equal to 1. But when my x is equal to 1, that is the third condition, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1, my output is generally no change. If you see for an AND gate latch, the output is no change. But can I consider as no change? Can I say when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, the p and q will remain equal to 1? No. I am considering my NAND gates as non-ideal. See, if it's ideal, then it's 1 and 1. It will remain in the previous state only, that is 1 and 1. But if it is non-ideal, what I can consider is that the gate 2, if I consider, has more delay than gate 1. That means what will happen is that my this output will be coming earlier than this output. So what they are considering is that when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, my P output will be coming earlier than Q output because my gate 1 has lesser delay than gate 2, and hence the Q output for the next state will be coming earlier. That is, Q is equal to P dot Y bar. Now P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1, P is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1, 1 bar is 0. Similarly, my P is equal to X dot Q bar is equal to x is equal to 1, my q has come as 0, therefore 0 bar is equal to 1. So when my x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, my p can be 1, q can be 0. And if I consider the gate 1 has more delay than gate 2, just you can do this calculation, you can get p as 0 and 1. And hence, if my x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, ideally as per the NAND gate truth table, there is no change in the output. It will remain in the earlier state only. So what should happen ideally is that it should remain in the state of x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, that is p is equal to 1, q is equal to 1, because that was my previous output. but it won't remain in the output in a non-ideal condition if my gates have certain difference in the delay, and you will get this output over here. So I hope I am very clear. The next class will be talking about D flip-flop as well. So if you like this particular video, do not forget to like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram as well. The description, the links are given down in the description box. And please do share it to as many people as you can, so it, because it's a very important concept and a very important topic as well. So thank you so much, guys. God bless you.